Welcome back to Warrior Vlogs. I don't know if this is going to be a third part of my first, my third vlog, or if I'm just going to start a new vlog with this clip. But anyways, today we're going to make some Viking arm braces. I saw the tutorial from Friis Forge. I'll have a link to his channel in the description. So I went ahead and bought 1 centimeter round stock because I couldn't find square stock at Lowe's. And we're going to see what we can do from here. I marked off 6 inches, and I'm going to start, fuller the middle, like he said, and then we're going to start working our ends out. I'm going to cut it off last, so I'm going to be able to work with the long stock for the whole video. Alright, the metal's almost heated up, so what I did was I took a tape measure and marked on my anvil with a silver pencil about 3 inches down. So that way when I pull it over here, I'll have a mark that I can start take the fullering peen and start fullering it down with the fuller, the peen hammer. What that'll do is create a thinner spot in the middle. That way it's able to bend so you can shape it to your arm when you're done. Alright, we got our fuller down in the middle, so it's thin, and then we're going to start working the edge out to a taper, so that way we can bend it around the arm. Alright, we got the metal heated up, we're going to start fullering it down, or tapering it down. Alright, we got it tapered down a little bit, but we got a long ways to go. Alright, we got it tapered down a little bit more, but still got a long ways to go. What I'm trying to do is make it perfectly square, so when we do the twist at the end, the twist comes out perfect and beautiful. Alright, I took my rounding hammer, and right in the center, I rounded it out so it's a lot thinner now, as you can see, and it's got a wider space. I'm going to put my mark, my symbol, right there. I'm going to engrave it there. And then this part over here is square. It's pretty close to square, especially if we're starting with a round bar. It's squared, so now we're going to taper the end out. It looks like it's almost long enough to fit around my arm. Or at least the fit around where I want it to. And it might be a little too long, actually. Anyways, I can shape it down. So we're going to taper that out, and we're going to start working on this side, working back. Alright, I'm going to have to heat it up again, but I got the square part stretched out as much as I want. I got the a little bit of a more distinct edge from where it's circle to where it squares off, and I got the tip tapered down a little bit. We're going to heat the tip up and taper it down one more time. We're going to start working on the other side. Alright, we finished tapering it down, now we can start working on the other side. Alright, the metal's almost heated up, so what we're going to do first is I've marked the anvil at 3 inches again. We're going to figure out where that 3-inch mark is, and then I'm going to fuller it down. And then I'm going to take the chisel and put a half cut in it so it cuts it halfway through. That way the metal can be separated with, and I can work both sides without splitting off completely. Alright, now we have the metal separated, we can work one side without affecting the other and not spread back and forth. Alright, we're starting to taper it down, and we're going to make it look just about like the other side. Alright, it's getting hard to work with it and along all the way across, so I'm going to have to cut it off and then flip it over and use my tongs and then hammer it that way, so that way I won't have that long piece of metal in the way. Alright, so I just cut it off, and now we're going to taper it out so it'll be almost the same length as the other one, and then we're going to put it on the horn of the anvil and wrap it. Alright, now the center is about as thin as we can get it right now, and each side is stretched out, so now what we're going to do is wrap it. We twisted one side, now we're going to twist the other so they match. Alright, both sides are almost the same. This one's a little too twisted, so we're going to have to take it out and untwist it. Alright, I did half a little bit of a reverse twist and gives that a nice ripple effect, so I'm going to do the same thing over here since I messed up. Alright, well that didn't work, but at least we have a twist in both sides. That's really all that I care about. So now I'm going to try and start wrapping it. Again, we're taking a wooden hammer. And just slowly wrapping it around the horn. Again, we're taking a wooden hammer. And just slowly wrapping it around the horn. Alright, so I've taken the metal, and on the two sides, I'm folding them inwards so that it kind of makes an S pattern, and then I'm wrapping it downwards so it rolls down, and then
stuff from BUDK, BUDK.com. It's a really good site for buying swords, knives, and survival equipment and stuff like that. And I bought myself a sword and a couple knives for me and my dad. So let's go ahead and get into it. As customary with all BUDK purchases, I think, it comes with a magazine. This one shows their switchblade for like $20 right now. It's only one direction, so that's why I haven't bought it. I want one that's two directions, but those are like $50. This magazine just shows you like most of the deals and a lot of the stuff they have online. I guess like any magazine. The lids fell off some of these boxes. Looks like the knives are okay then. I bought these Timberwolf handcrafted quality knives from Custom Steel Seared. It looked really nice online. Let's see how they look in real life. I bought four of them because my dad wanted some. And it was like 2 for $6 was the deal at the time. And so I went ahead and bought four. They have a acid etching on the metal with these leafy flower designs and this really nice redwood. And the blade is really smooth. It's made by Timberwolf.
You can see there, acid etching. There's the blade. It's a really nice knife. It's got the grip bar. Acid etchings on both sides. It's a really nice knife.
The only thing I don't like about it is the releases on the back. I prefer knives like this, how the release is on the front right there. So you push that in, and then the knife folds up, so you can use it with one hand rather than two. So let's see. There's two of the other Timberwolf knives. There's the other one. And then... go ahead and open one. These are my dad bought a boat recently. And so he wants a couple fillet knives to go on his boat for fishing. They come with a nice plastic sheath. It's really nice. It fits well onto the blade. But it doesn't come out very easy. This is the Wahoo Killer fillet knife. It's got a nice belt clip. It's very, very strong and sturdy. Let's see. The blade is pretty sharp, straight out of the box. Yeah, very sharp right out of the box. It's got a very nice rubber grip that, so you don't lose it while you're fishing or dealing with water and stuff. The plastic orange for, be able to see it very nice. And that's the Wahoo Killer. I think they're like $2 on BUDK. My dad wanted four of those for his boat, so we got that. And then here's the baby I've been waiting for. My Gladius. This is the United Cutlery Tactical Gladiator Sword. Combat Commander Gladiator. Here's the picture of the sword. This video I've been watching online for a long time now. Got a very nice nylon sheath with a plastic or flax leather, I think, tip to the sheath. It's really nice. It's got a good belt loop there, as you can see. Let's go ahead and get the rest of the blade open. Okay. It's perfect size, fits my hand really nice. This is about the size of a Gladius. Ooh, wow, I can already tell through the plastic that this blade is very nice and sharp. Straight out of the box. Let's go ahead and get it open. It's got a little, grease or... It looks like grease on it from the plastic. Keep the blade clean. Or something, I'll have to wipe that off. But it's really nice. It's got a hole in the center of the handle. I guess that's to relieve weight. I'm not really sure, but I like it. It looks nice. Let's see. Alright, it's got the glass breaker on the back, the nice pommel, and the hilt. Very nice. It's smooth, nice plastic handle. It's very nice. It looks like grease on the blade. Yeah, Combat Commander High Carbon Steel United Cutlery. Made in China, of course. But I like how the blade has that curve to it. It's styled after Gladius Hispanicus, used by the Roman Empire. It's got a very nice swing to it. I really like it. The fit in the sheath can come out nicely. Oh yeah, the sheath works perfectly fine. It goes in and out of the sheath, really nice. If the zombie apocalypse comes, this is definitely the sword I'll be using. It's, all I can say is it's really nice. It's exactly what I've been looking for. It was like $20 online, I think. $26, $28, something like that. It wasn't too bad for the sword. I definitely give it a high review. a high carbon steel. It said it had a full tang, but I'm not sure it does with that hole in the center. It might be a half tang with the tang only coming down to here. The difference is a full tang. The tang, the piece of metal that the blade is made out of, goes all the way to the back. It might be with just a hole drilled in it. The piece of metal goes all the way to the back, and that gives it more strength. Rather than a half tang where it only goes halfway through it. It's just not as strong that way. Online it said it was a full tang, so I guess I'll trust them. They probably just drilled a hole through the tang right there. Yeah, this thing only weighs probably half a pound, maybe 1 pound. It's very light. I really like it. It fits really nice in the hand. So. Alright, I guess this is a short video, but that's all for today. I hope y'all liked it. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And if there's anything you see I can do better, let me know. And I will definitely try to. Thank y'all for watching. Y'all have a good day.